Good evening, Ospreys. I'm Connor Spoonmaker, and this is your OTV News, powered by the Spinnaker. A large group of students gathered on the green yesterday after a man began yelling at students about his religious beliefs. The Spinnaker's Gordon Ryan has the story.
Out here on the UNF green, Brother Gary Birdsaw and other UNF students have been practicing their First Amendment rights in a rather heated discussion over politics and religion.
This rapper had 10 wives, had children all around him. And you know what he said? They would have a serious life. I don't know how this happened.
Well, I preach on university campuses all over the United States. Well, I'm trying to tell people that's hope in Jesus, but it ain't hope in the world system. Because universities is full of people coming in with different beliefs, and they got their beliefs. And when I come out, a lot of people don't say much about their beliefs until I come out. Then you got all kind of people's into religions and all, and I'm telling them what the Bible says. They said, no, it's not true, and I try to say it is, da, da, da. So that's when you got all this going on, in a sense.
Birdsaw travels the United States, preaching to many college campuses. UNF students had reactions of their own, but most of them negative.
I'm glad he's here in a way because he needs to hear the truth. Disrespecting women, people of color, Jews. He doesn't understand maybe that Jesus was a Jew. He doesn't understand that women have power.
I truly believe that anyone can have their own view on religion, but I don't think anyone has the right to judge someone else or someone else's lifestyle based on what they believe. Anyone can believe what they want.
One student claimed he was told by Birdsaw that he was going to hell for masturbating and smoking marijuana. Another student claimed that she was told she was going to hell because she was a feminist. Birdsaw said he plans to wrap up his trip of the state by visiting Tampa as well as the University of Florida. This has been Gordon Ryan, OTV News.
On average, we touch our faces over 3,000 times a day, and each time is a risk for developing the flu. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the number of outpatient visits for a reported flu-like illness doubled from the national baseline in the first week of 2013. In 2008, Google introduced a tool called Google Flu Trends that uses searches on flu-like symptoms to predict outbreaks in areas. The analytics predict flu development in Jacksonville to be highly intense. Director of UNF Student Health Services, Doreen Perez, said since returning from break, there has been an increase in flu-like symptoms amongst UNF students. Student Health Services received so many requests for the flu vaccine in the past week that the department decided to open an impromptu clinic in the conference room to administer extra flu vaccines. The CDC cites an annual flu vaccine as the most effective way of protecting oneself from acquiring the flu. According to the CDC, this year's flu vaccine is found to be 62% effective. The vaccine costs students $15, and Perez stresses that the clinic is willing to work with students to help students pay for the vaccine so that money is not an excuse for not getting vaccinated. CCI Aguilar is with us now to let us know what kind of weather to expect for the upcoming three-day weekend.
Thanks, Connor. Hey, Ospreys, I'm CC Aguilar, and this is your OTV weather forecast. Cooler temperatures will be moving in with the rain today. Let's check out our precipitation map to see how long this will last into your three-day weekend. Today, we have a 30% chance of rain all day and throughout the night. We will start to clear up into the weekend with about a 20% chance of rain. And then on Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, we will see less than a 5% chance of rain all throughout the Jacksonville area. Now, let's take a look at our five-day forecast. Today we will see a high of 75 with a chance for showers, and the cold weather will breeze in tonight with a low of 43. Tomorrow there will be winds up to 21 miles per hour moving in from the northeast with a cold high of 62. Saturday will be mostly sunny with a high of 66. Sunday won't be that different with a high of 67, mostly sunny as well. And then on Martin Luther King Day we will stick with that colder weather and a high of 66. Most of the week's lows will be in the mid-40s and low 50s. Have you wondered what that yellow film is on your car? Well, it's pollen, pine pollen to be exact, and it's also causing your seasonal allergies to flare up. For the next 3 days, we will continue to see this high pine pollen level, so wait to wash your car and don't forget your tissues. Remember, for your latest updates on weather, check out OspreyTV.com. For your OTV News, I'm CeCe Aguilar.
Thanks, CeCe. The Filipino Student Association will host a benefit concert this Sunday at 6 p.m. in the Student Union Ballrooms. The concert, which costs $10, will benefit nonprofit organization Gawad Kalinga. It will be hosted by YouTube comedians from Wasabi Productions. Performing artists include R&B group Carissa Ray and Michael Alvarado and Orlando rapper Southstar. FSA President Patrick Lumang said last year's concert raised about $2,000 with about 300 people in attendance. He also said this year's event hopes to raise around $3,000. An after-party hosted by Salazar will follow the concert and will be $5 for anyone with a valid student ID. De'Anthony Davesan is with us now to let us know what kind of events are going on in Jacksonville this weekend.
Hey Ospreys, I'm De'Anthony Davesan, and this is your Jax News. Tonight through Monday, Ringling Brothers Barnum & Bailey Circus is a perfect event for family and friends to gather and watch a high wire balancing act, 13 exotic cats, a handful of animals, and a woman shoot out of a cannon. This event starts tonight at 7:30 p.m. at the Veterans Memorial Arena. Tickets start at $10. For more information, go to jaxevents.com. Friday, enjoy comedian Jerry Seinfeld as he will perform his stand-up routine at the Times Union Center at 7 p.m. Tickets start at $55 and are available at the Veterans Memorial Arena and online at Ticketmaster.com. On Saturday, the King of Rock and Roll lives on in a musical to entertain all audiences. The musical will also pay tribute to Anne Margaret. This event is at 7 p.m. Tickets start at $40. Sunday at 7:30, Yonder Mountain String Band is playing at Freebird Live. The band has a mix of bluegrass, rock, and many other influences. You can buy your tickets in advance online at freebirdlive.com for $22.50. That's all the Jax News I have for you today, Ospreys. Have a safe and awesome weekend. See you next time.
Thanks, Yoffany. Josh Brannick is now with us to let you know what's going on in the sports world.
Thanks, Connor. Hey, Ospreys, I'm Josh Brannick here with your sports look ahead. The UNF men's basketball team look to pick up a big conference win this weekend. The Ospreys will host crosstown rival JU tomorrow at 7 p.m. at the UNF Arena. Dating back to the 2011 A-Sun Conference playoffs, UNF has won the last three meetings between the two rivals. The team is 8-11 on the season with a 3-3 conference record. UNF is coming off of an 81-72 win over Kennesaw State last Saturday. The UNF women's basketball team will also look to pick up a big rivalry win against JU. The team will host the Dolphins the day after the men's game. JU will enter the UNF Arena on Saturday to play the Ospreys at 2 p.m. UNF has won four out of the last five meetings between the two teams. The Ospreys are 7-10 on the year with a 3-3 conference record. The UNF women's tennis team will be participating in the FGCU invite starting on Saturday and ending on Monday. The Jacksonville Jaguars rebuilding process is continuing to take shape this evening. The Jags announced earlier today that Seattle Seahawks defensive coordinator Gus Bradley will be joining new GM Dave Caldwell as the team attempts to turn around a 2-14 Jags team from this past season. Bradley will be formally introduced tomorrow at a press conference. The Seahawks have announced that they have hired University of Florida's defensive coordinator Dan Quinn to replace Bradley. And in college football, the lore of Notre Dame star Manti Te'o is in question after Deadspin.com reported that his girlfriend, who died of leukemia the same week his grandmother died, never actually existed. It is still unsure whether Te'o was a part of the ruse or was a victim of a hoax. Well, going to the Jags, I'm really liking the way that the Jags are moving this year. I like Caldwell, and I think this is a great hire for a team to move forward.
It'd be nice, you know, to have a team that's actually winning every once in a while.
But it would be nice to actually go to a game and see a win.
Yeah, it would be nice, but, you know, Detroit Lions, still my team. Always will be. Ospreys, this is all we have for you tonight. Check us out anytime at OspreyTV.com or right here on Campus Channel 170. Have a great holiday weekend.